Many, many years ago, that song was written by John, and how many it has comforted down through the years. And it's a song we sing in life, and it's a song that we sing in the conclusion of life, and it's an amazing grace that we'll sing forever throughout the endless ages. We have a wonderful, wonderful Savior. Those that are saved by God's grace know that to be so. Others that have not yet been touched by that grace that Brother Brian taught, they're missing something that they know not of. It's tremendous. And we rejoice exceedingly in the faith of Hazel Fitzwater and how that her faith was placed in the Lord Jesus Christ. Very gifted. When I think of the works here that represent her handiwork, the Lord truly gifted her. And that's here to be exampled before us. And back there on the table, I believe those two were made by her. And so I'm glad that there's a good conclusion to a life that's born into sin. Aren't you? Aren't you so thankful that we don't have to die that way? We have life that's offered us, and when that life is received, it turns our life into an absolute blessing. And we can really rejoice when it comes to a time like this. Often, we read scriptures, and in Virginia, I'm from Virginia, we have a time set aside where we read some scriptures before we actually get into the message. And I want to do that just a little bit. I've got a message here, but I want you to turn to Psalms chapter 23. Psalms 23 is a very fitting verse or passage of scripture, 6 short verses. And I want to read those verses. The first thing I want us to understand and realize is that Psalms 23 is a very personal psalm. It speaks to us as individuals. And Psalms 23 has 17 personal pronouns, which shows you the Father heart of God, the shepherd heart of God. He says, and it reads, "The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me into the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil." She's been there. But it's a wonderful thing when you know him, amen. He says, "I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. For thou art with me, and thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." She had a personal shepherd to lead her on in this life and on into that which is to come. Now, how can these things be? It is not our worthiness, but it's Calvary's love that made that possible. Let me read this psalm again to you. "The Lord is my shepherd because of Calvary. I shall not want because of Calvary. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures because of Calvary. He leadeth me beside the still waters because of Calvary. He restoreth my soul because of Calvary. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake because of Calvary. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil because of Calvary, for thou art with me because of Calvary. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me because of Calvary. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies because of Calvary. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life because of Calvary. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever because of Calvary." Isn't that wonderful? Every rich blessing that we have is because of Calvary. Now let me read it again in another light. "To the lost, there is a dreadful realization that can be seen in the negative. And she didn't have to see it this way, but there have been some that have tasted the bitterness of what I'm about to read from the very same psalm. The Lord is not, I'm adding the negative, the Lord is not my shepherd, I shall want. He does not make me to lie down in green pastures. He does not lead me beside the still waters. He does not restore my soul. He does not lead me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear evil, for thou art not with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they do not comfort me. Thou dost not prepare a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou dost not anoint my head with oil. My cup does not run over. Surely goodness and mercy shall not follow me all the days of my life, and I will not dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Boy, I'm telling you, if that's a man's record, that'd be horrible, wouldn't it? Can you imagine that? Now, Psalms 23 is the Old Testament Great Shepherd chapter. And the Great Good Shepherd chapter in the New Testament is John chapter number 10. In John chapter 10, it is the Lord Jesus who is the Good Shepherd. And we know that the Lord Jesus is the same as the Jehovah of the Old Testament. And thus I read this same psalm again, the Lord Jesus is my shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord Jesus maketh me to lie down in green pastures. The Lord Jesus leadeth me beside the still waters. The Lord Jesus restoreth my soul. The Lord Jesus leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou, Lord Jesus, art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. The Lord Jesus prepares a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou, Lord Jesus, anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord Jesus forever. Aren't you grateful for Calvary? Aren't you thankful for his love? Just one more time, let me read it again. I shall not want because the Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. I shall not want for rest. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. I shall not want for refreshment. He leadeth me beside the still waters. I shall not want for forgiveness. He restoreth my soul. I shall not want for guidance. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. I shall not want for companionship. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. I shall not want for comfort, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. I shall not want for provision. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. I shall not want for joy. Thou anointest my head with oil. I shall not want for divine favor. My cup runneth over, and I shall not want for anything in the life to come. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall not want for anything in this life and anything in the life to come. I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Do we not have a blessed hope? We truly and genuinely have a wonderful hope because we know the Lord Jesus Christ.